The down days of summer are a perfect time for parents to get their kids up to speed on skills needed for school success.
And if your child has learning differences, there might be extra things you can do. Chrissie Kahan is an assistant principal who focuses much of her time working with students who need special learning plans. And her new book, Catsberger, gives young children a special understanding of autism and Asperger's. How are you?
Good to have you back here with us.
Thanks for having me, my favorite local news team.
Thank you.
So let's talk about autism and Asperger's.
Sure.
It's such a wide range.
It is. Huge spectrum.
Yeah, so, and I think probably a lot of adults, much less children, don't understand it. So tell us about the book. What's the point of it? How is it going to help?
So I really think in education, we need to start doing a better job of training and advocacy and teaching kids the differences between the different types of disabilities, especially mental disabilities. Autism is a huge spectrum. Mm-hmm. It affects 1 in 62 kids.
Wow.
And the population that I see missing is high-functioning autism.
So I work, what do you mean by high functioning autism?
So Asperger's.
Okay.
That is a part of the autism spectrum. Great question. And it is high functioning autism. And those are the kids I see in the elementary school level that are often misdiagnosed.
Oh.
You know, teachers need more training on high functioning autism, and there aren't placements for them.
Are they often also missed because their grades, which is usually a teacher's and parents' first signal that something's going on, their grades are good, right?
Yeah, they're usually very intelligent.
Yeah.
You know, they focus on a specific area that they're interested in. So think Sheldon from Big Bang Theory.
We've seen the show right here on CBS and News Channel 3.
That is a perfect representation of high-functioning autism.
Gotcha.
And so because they look smart, they're normal, they appear normal, they're very smart, it often gets misdiagnosed, and then they have difficulty acknowledging, like, social gestures.
Gotcha.
They often talk about a topic of interest. So really educating kids on the differences.
So the other kids don't think they're weird.
Exactly.
Right?
Well, you mentioned training, though. How early, how soon should that begin, and where?
So we often think that teachers just know, you know, all the signs of ADHD, anxiety, parents too. They don't. One little special education class in your training as a teacher is just not cutting it these days.
Mm-hmm.
Especially with all the bullying we're seeing, all the school shootings. You know, it's really a scary time in education. And I look back at those kids, specifically Parkland, Nicholas Cruz.
Yeah.
He was a shooter. He had PTSD.
Yeah.
He had high-functioning autism. This is something the school checked off the boxes. They tried to get him help, but there weren't enough resources, so he got mixed in with behavioral learning kids as opposed to, you know, an understanding that he has this disorder.
Do you think that's a common mistake a lot of schools, a lot of school districts make these days?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I think it goes back to training.
Yeah.
And that's really why I've dedicated my time, you know, writing these books.
Yeah.
I had a student come up to me with my book with the little cat and say, I'm sassy.
The cat in the book who has Asperger's.
Who has Asperger's. And he finally figured it out. This was a kid who had ADHD.
Yeah.
And so there are ways for parents to help, ways for teachers to help, and ways for peers to help.
So if parents read this book, let's say they have a young child, they recognize some of sassy in their child.
Yes.
Are there things the parent can do over the summer to help get the child ready?
Absolutely. The book is a great talking point.
Yeah.
It's a great start for them to realize, hey, I might have this. You know, also read it with their friends, might want to take it into the teacher.
Gotcha.
Each school has that student support team where they diagnose kids, get them the right plans.
Right.
That's also a good avenue for parents to go, along with talking to their pediatrician, because there are like Facebook groups and you can find other parents who have kids with those needs and you really feel that bond.
Because it's important to have that support out there, to say the least.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Okay.
It is. Thank you
Chrissie,
so much
for your
work.
Glad to have you back
here. Thank you so much. You guys are fabulous.
Good to have you.
Thank you.